Hi friends and welcome back to bankexamstoday.com. So SBI PO notification is out and many of you requested me to make a video on SBI PO. So today we will discuss how to start the preparations for SBI PO 2017. So first of all, let me tell you the exam pattern. There are three sections, same as IBPS PO 2017, 100 questions are there, 1 hour is allotted, there is quantitative aptitude, consists of 35 marks, 35 questions are there, then 35 marks for reasoning and 30 marks for English. So let's discuss about quantitative aptitude, the QT. In QT, 35 marks, there is data interpretation. There will be 3 to 4 sets, about 15 to 20 marks will be allotted to them. So don't expect the simple one diagram question, simple, you know, pie chart, simple table. Don't expect that. There will be, most probably there will be double diagram sets, and there will be questions like missing figures. Very important, missing figures table. Some of the figures will be missing and you need to find those figures. And then there will be, first of all, what I have noticed in SBI PO exam is that first of all the examiner asks you to you know bring the data, you know, solve the data first. First of all you need to find the gross profit, first of all you need to find the expenditure, you need to find the simple interest, a compound interest, then out of that information you need to solve that set. So DI is not going to be easy, in fact it is difficult. I have shared a data interpretation workbook on bankexamstoday.com. So I have picked many questions from previous papers, from IBPS PO and even SBI PO, SBI Clerk, from previous papers. I have compiled all those questions and I have made an ebook, and that ebook is available for free. You can find the link in the description. So that's all for the data interpretation part. Further, I have made a page, data interpretation guide, on bankexamstoday.com. You can, you know, go through that guide. I am updating that guide every week. I am providing PDF files, sets, a lot of things there. So that is my take on data interpretation. Then in quantitative aptitude section, my fav topic, that is series, number series. So series, I have already made a full-fledged video lecture for the number series chapter. I'll drop the link in the description. So series, what kind of series questions are asked in the exam? There'll be 5 questions. So the next important chapter here is the series, number series. So I have already made a separate video on number series. I'll provide the link in the description. So what kind of questions generally we see in the SBI PO or IBPS PO exam? They're like, you need to find the trend. You need to find the logic. You can solve these questions within 15-20 seconds. So normally it's like, for example, I am taking the example, these are examples, A, B, C, D. It'd be like, that is the difference between B and A. So easy, seems to be easy, but sometimes it is difficult to find these kind of logics in the exam. So according to me, you will find at least 5 questions from this chapter. 5 marks, 5 questions from this chapter. There can be data sufficiency. I know many of you might argue that data sufficiency is a reasoning chapter, but data sufficiency questions can also be in the QT section, DS. I have already made a separate ebook for data sufficiency. There can be 0 to 5. That's why I'm writing 0 to 5. Questions are 0 to 5 marks from this chapter. I have made a separate practice book for data sufficiency. You can find the link in the description, and that is also available for free. Then there are miscellaneous questions. In miscellaneous, there are time and work. Time and distance. Time and work, time and distance, simple and compound interest, ratios, problems based on ages, averages. Then there are some chapters like problems based on trains. So that is also, that is a part of time and distance chapter. Further, there are allegation, and that concept is same as a time and work. So I'm not writing those chapters again. So you'll be finding at least, you know, 7 to 10 marks from this part. So according to me, it is easy to fetch 5 and 10 marks from the QT section. Then this part is a bit difficult than this part. So series is the easiest chapter. One chapter that I missed here is simplification. Simplification can or cannot be the part of the QT section. You can find 0 to 5 questions from simplification. So simplification is normally the part of that SBI clerk or IBPS clerk exam, but sometimes we see this, the complex calculation problems in the simplification chapter. So that's all for the QT syllabus. So let's discuss about the various study material, the various ebooks, the hard copy books available in the market. Yes, so let's discuss about the various study material available for the QT section. So first of all, I don't recommend the R.S. Agarwal book, the MTIRA books. I don't recommend those books. There are few good books available in the market. The first one is Arun Sharma. That is kind of, you know, average book, not that bad, not that good. But the good book that I recommend is The Quantum Cat by Sarvesh Kumar Verma. That is a very good book. You should buy that. Sarvesh Kumar Verma, I don't know that person, and they didn't pay me to recommend their book, but I have gone through their book and that book is very good. Go for it. But if you are looking for some ebooks or free study material, you know, I have made a data interpretation ebook. I have made a data sufficiency ebook, a 200 short questions are there. So I'm providing the links to all those ebooks in the description. Further, I have made a video lecture series, right? And I'm providing that video lecture series in a pen drive. Further, so there is a pen drive containing the video courses, plus there are ebooks, plus there are test series. So you'll be getting all that bundle in the description, and you'll be getting the link here. So that is the QT section. That's all about the QT section. So let's discuss about the reasoning section. In reasoning, there will be puzzles. Puzzles are a bit difficult here, you know. I expect 10 to 15 marks from the puzzles. You'll be finding there are puzzles like there are 8 people, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. A is a doctor, B is an engineer, C is again some teacher, he's a scientist. Then X is a wife of A, Y is a wife of is B, then there is Z is a wife of C, and Y is the son of C. So So there'll be conditions like that, and you need to complete that table. So these are the kind of questions that we see in the SBI PU exam. So there'll be like 10 to 15 marks for this particular topic. I have made an ebook for the puzzles. The link will be available in the description, and that PDF is available for free. The second part, seating arrangement. There will be 7-8 people, you know, sitting in a circular arrangement or in a, you know, rectangular arrangement. You know, it'll be like this, 6, 8, 10 people. They are sitting. Some people are facing inside, some people are facing outside. So you need to complete the arrangement and answer the questions. So there will be like 5 to 10 marks, most probably 5 marks for seating arrangement. Then there will be inequalities, very easy topic. I have already shared a technique. The link will be available in the description. Then series again. So there will be alphabetical series. The series is a little bit different from the series asked in that quantitative aptitude section. Sometimes 5 questions from the reasoning section is asked, and 5 questions from QT is asked. So total 10 questions from series chapter is asked in the exam. Then there is coding, decoding. Zero to 5 marks again. And there are miscellaneous topics. For example, data sufficiency, you can find 0 to 5 marks. Then problems based on ages, again 0 to 2 marks, 0 to 1, actually 2. Blood relations, again 0 to 2 marks. Direction sense problems, so 0 to 2 marks. So these are the questions, these are the chapters that are important for SBI PU exam. Not important, that is actually the syllabus for the SBI PU exam. So let's discuss about the various books that are important and that are useful for SBI PU exam for the reasoning section. Again, I don't recommend the RS Agarwal book. According to me, no good books are available in the market for the reasoning section. Yes, I have gone through, you know, dozens of books, but I'm not satisfied with any of them. In the quantitative aptitude section, there are some good books available. Sarvesh Kumar Verma is there, Arun Sharma is there, Nishit Sinha. That is a very difficult book. If you are looking for a very difficult book for quantitative aptitude section, go for Nishit Sinha. Very difficult book. Go for that. For the reasoning ability, no good books are available in the market. You know, you need to find out the free PDFs or paid ebooks available online. I have also a ebook, and that is also available for free, and the link is available in the description. But I don't recommend any book, you know, that is available in the market. But if you love to read from, you know, hard copy books, you can take the printouts, or you can, you know, buy some magazines by BSE. You can buy the BSE magazines, or those magazines are very good. You can buy those magazines and solve the practice. You know, there are many other magazines available in the market, but I don't recommend any other magazine. The magazine by BSE is good, but IBPS Chronicle is also there. Maybe that is by Arihant, but BSE is good. Go for that. Let's talk about the English section. Sorry. The syllabus of English is very easy. There is an RC, you know, there will be 10 marks for the RC, 5 questions, and then there will be 2-3 vocab questions, and there will be synonyms from the RC. So in RC, the question will be like, what is the theme of the passage? What is the suitable title of the passage? What is the tone of the author? So these kind of questions are going to be asked in the exam. So if you are not reading any newspaper, then you should start reading newspaper today, because the tone of the author, you know, the what should be the title of the paragraph, these kind of question can only be answered if you read the newspaper daily. If you have the reading habit, then only you can answer those questions. Then there is error spotting, 10 marks for error spotting, 5 to 10 marks actually. From last few exam, I have seen 10 from RC and then 10 for error spotting. Then there can be closed test. There can be 0 to 10 marks. Then most of the time, these are the topics that are, you know, that's what we see in the exams. So the last one is like para jumbles. 0 to 5 marks. So that is the syllabus for the English language. So what are the various books that you should follow? Again, there are, for the grammar, you can follow any book available in the market. The one that I recommend is by Murphy, and that is a good book. There is a Ren and Martin book, that is also a good book. The English Grammar by Ren and Martin, that is also a good book. By Raymond Murphy, I personally, you know, have Raymond Murphy, that is also a good book. I have made grammar notes, you know, with the help of the editorial team. You can download the notes for free. The link is available in the description. For the error spotting and the para jumbles, you need practice. You know, for the RC, right, or the closed test, you can, you know, crack these topics without even practice, you know, just by, you know, reading. If you have that, you know, reading hobby, the hobby of reading the newspaper, then you don't even need the practice. But to solve the para jumbles and error spotting, you need to, you know, practice a lot of questions. From where you can find those practice sets, I have made a separate ebook for error spotting. The link is available, again, the link is available in the description. For para jumbles, I don't have an ebook as of now, but I'll be making an ebook soon, and within a week or so. I have also made a model paper for SBI PO exam. You can find the link in the description again. So if you just have started your preparations, then I recommend you to buy my pen drive course. We are providing the video lectures, all the ebooks for all the sections. Whether we are providing a test series, online test series, it is a national wide test series. So all the links in the description. Subscribe our channel, you know, press like. Maybe within a week or so, I'm going to take your questions and I'm going to answer all the questions in a live video. So that's all for today. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe, click the subscribe button. I don't know why people just watch the videos and don't click the subscribe. Please subscribe our channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.